But it doesn't mean that the mountain still mountains doesn't matter.
It was done about 5 or 6 years before I met. that's a big discussion between standard psychology and economic psychology. So that's always the tradition. Can you actually reveal the standard of modeling, more genius to the modeling? And that's a big debate. But I would at least think that most of the relationships you show are reasonable. That's what I would say. So the question is probably adding to our direction of the science of cognitive reform. But there is this discussion, can we actually measure the self justice? And often we have to run that as well. Normally the results are more reliable
than the last question. I think one of the reasons that economists came late to think about entrepreneurship is a lot of what's being written was issues with preferences and analogies to risk and failure and things like that. And economists study behavior, you know, the classic, we study decisions people make and not how they make those decisions. And so it's not wasn't very attractive there. I think one general thing that comes from this paper is that we can get at these as an economist by writing down simple models. If my psychological story is true, what does it say about learning? Well, it may say something about the variance of learning, it may say something about average learning, about the relationships between that and the choices that we make. And so if you're willing to write down a simple model, you can then tackle some of these issues as an economist rather than as a psychologist. And there's still very little done on that. Lazier, for example, wouldn't touch on this. Yet there were some of these data in the Stanford survey. And we know there were, because Stanford only cared about how rich these people were. That's why they did the survey. It was the alumni development office that did the survey, fundraising office. But we haven't done very well in this paper because of the data set we had. And at some point, you know, sometimes you get it, even as economists, we suffer from the sunk cost fallacy. And there was a point at which we should have said, maybe we should use a different data set. I think it was probably around the fifth journal rejection that we should have done that. And we had a choice between getting a new data set and doing it again, or really lowering the journal that we submitted to. And life is short, so we submitted it to a lowering journal. But simple models can bridge that issue of psychology. Simple models about throw that psychological issue in there and say, does it say something novel about the relationship between learnings and choices that a traditional model does not say? You know, so as economists, we can make progress on that.
Yeah, thank you very much. I think we should have